In Svizzera sono 2600 i comuni, 1000.
Hundreds of city and town mayors coming from all over the Italian peninsula gathered in Rome on Tuesday to manifest their deep dissatisfaction with the spending cuts planned by the government led by Mario Monti. The technocratic prime minister has recently presented a spending review decree which includes cuts in the public sector for 26 billion euro in 3 years. Local municipalities' 2012 budgets have been slashed by 500 million euros, while further 2 billion euros will be cut next year. Moreover, Monti has reintroduced a property tax which was once designed to raise revenue to local municipalities. However, in the Monti reintroduction, the central government intends to take 50% of this revenue, even though municipalities will still be responsible for collecting the tax.
Perché le risorse sono poche.
Our budgets had been approved not long ago, resources had been allocated, deals with public and private institutions had been signed. These across-the-board cuts are dreadful. And what about the house tax? Monti turned Italian mayors into mere tax collectors.
The government should not axe the budget of the municipalities. It should cut instead the excessive central government staffing costs. Why hasn't Monti started from there?
A delegation of mayors was received by the president of the Italian Senate, to whom they expressed their concern over the future of Italian municipalities. The National Association of the Italian Municipalities said that if the government is not willing to enter into negotiation with the mayors, it will have to face a sturdy opposition.
After the public spending cuts, the Monti-led government has presented a plan to relocate some of the country's courts in order to eliminate small and inefficient local offices. The plan aims at reducing legal procedure and improving the justice system.
Monti's spending review will lead to eliminating roughly 30 courts, 37 prosecutors' offices and over 200 judicial offices. This is totally unlawful and it is unfair. Thousands of people will be forced to travel long distances to attend court hearings.
Monti has recently said in his very technical Italian that by introducing new spending cuts, the government opted to discard the easiest path of across-the-board cuts in order to go down a more complex road, but one that is structurally profitable according to analysis of the spending structure. Monti's harsh measure may have lost him the support of the Italian people. Whether he will maintain the political support of the members of the parliament in the long run remains to be seen. Max Civili, Press TV, Rome.